You all represent the future. You have a chance to change everything that you see in sports. It doesn't have to be the way you see it right now. It could be your beverage that becomes the preferred beverage of the NBA because you designed that beverage. That's crazy, man. You think about it, but you have that ability because you deposited so many things along the way into that bag. And what better to deposit than knowledge? Because nobody can ever take it away from you.
So I'm here for my foundation to teach you guys to be prepared, be ready, and to live your legacy, build your legacy, you know, starting at an early age.
I have polycystic kidney disease, which is PKD for short, where I have a whole lot of cysts inside of my kidneys, and I had to stop playing basketball because it's a contact sport.
So I had to flip everything in life, start over, and then use my mind to get over the sorrow of what I was passionate for, but put that same passion in what could I do for other people, like physical therapy and all that. Like, I love all that stuff. So it's a good outlook on it now.
Find what it is that you love, that you want to do, and then immerse yourself in it and try to be great at it.
That's really why you're here today, to learn a little bit more. We want to help you guys have a passion for the business and effort as well. Does that sound good?
The greatest talent you can have is a work ethic, because it is a talent.
Any more questions?
My question was, have you ever made a mistake that you regret making?
If you make a mistake, own up to it. Just own up to it. And don't blame somebody else. Don't just say, I screwed up. I'm sorry for it. I'm going to try to fix it.
Going after that steal, taking that shot, taking that hard class. You guys got to try, right? Because if you don't try, you'll never know. So what you don't want is to have regret. So I think we're going to say this on three, no fear, all right? No fear on three together. One, two, three.
No fear.
One, two, three.
No fear.
Just going out there to the gym or just running around, like actually, like, what am I trying to do? What's gonna be the most effective for me to be successful? And can I do these things every single day?
What you think you wanna be or think you should be, a lot of times people that care about you or see your characteristics, they'll lead you to where you're supposed to be.
Hello everyone, I'm Ricky Davis. I played NBA basketball for 13 years.
I'm Travell Gaines, and I'm the founder of Athletic Games Training Facility.
Adrian Wojnarowski, the editor of TheVertical.com on Yahoo Sports.
My name is Kevin Burleson. I'm a player development coach for the Houston Rockets from Seattle, Washington.
I'm Green. I run a nonprofit called Sport to Grades, which is involved in stimulating STEM education and enrichment of student athletes.
Hi, I'm Joe Branch, adjunct professor here in sports business. Division at Rice University, also at Rock Nation. I'm managing director of basketball. Excited to be here for Game Breakers Rice.
What I wanted them to take from this was just a little knowledge on how to prepare themselves to get to the post-secondary school, to kind of get to the next level. The what next motive is just to have your core courses, your GPA, and all the things that the NCAA requires for you to make it to a Division I.
I was fortunate enough today to be a part of the Game Breakers event here at Rice University. Great group of young people, high school students. As we talked about our careers and our jobs and the things we do within and around the sports world, hopefully we were able to give them some perspective and context that you don't have to make the NBA or become a pro football player or even get a Division I scholarship or a sports scholarship to have a career around sports. There's a lot of avenues. And almost every one of them begins with education.
It was a blessing and an honor to come down to Rice University and talk to these future leaders of America in the sports business. And I think that this event gave them a chance to take away some key components, which it would take for them to be successful in life, what's it take for them to be successful in sports, and hopefully we'll point them in the right direction and gave them just a little bit of tidbits for what they need to attain and reach all their goals.
I think sports management, that's a field that a lot of young people can get into. I think at first it was always like, if you're going to sports, you have to play. But you can see the GMs nowadays are younger. You know, they're loving having them play the game, or play the game, any kind of type of sport. But they have a good knowledge of the game, and they're doing great things. So I think for these young kids, it's good to see that. And you know, with this event, Game Breakers, it was great to see these young minds ask these questions about sports management.
It's crazy the amount of things you can do in the field of sports. It's a multi-billion dollar industry, and Rice is at the cutting edge of trying to help kids understand just how big it is.
So, you know, as advice for the future, as I said to those guys, know the competition. I know that the competition is global. Like I told them, I went to college in Chicago, I'm from Houston, and I work and I live in New York, but you know, there are a ton of students in their same seats in China, and Chile, and the Philippines, and you know, Africa, Europe, a lot of different places that want the same positions, jobs that they want. So just know that the competition is global.
It's a great thing, and you know, I just applaud Rice because you know, it's one of the best events I've ever been to. And I, you know, thank you guys for having it for these young kids.
Black Beatles in the city, be back immediately to confiscate the money.
Rice Girl.
That girl is a real crowd please. Small world, all her friends know of me. Young bull living like an old king. Quick release the cash, watch it fall slowly.